Hey everybody, it's Camille, and this is my friend Jules and her thoroughbred Bello. Today we're going to be working on trailer loading, and hopefully we're going to teach you guys how to get your horse through similar issues. So Jules, do you want to tell me a little bit about Bello?
So Bello is a 17-year-old thoroughbred. He never made it to the track. He's a little anxious. So it kind of shows in all things that he does. Mm-hmm. We had an issue back in October where he got kicked by a horse walking into my straight load trailer, and ever since then,
hi buddy, back up.
Ever since then, he doesn't want to walk on.
So what kind of issues does he have?
He starts balking and just kind of like pacing back and forth, and just kind of will take two steps forward and then realizes like, oh, my head can't get in, and then just backs right off.
All right, so why don't you go ahead and show us the issues you've been having.
All right.
Yeah.
Camille McCutcheon, horse whisperer. Let's see how she handles this wild horse.
So what I'm going to do with Bello is I'm going to have the trailer be his rest spot. So I'm never going to apply pressure when he's making active movements towards the trailer. That's when I'm going to take the pressure away. I'm also not going to stand in the trailer and try and pull him in. But what I'm going to be doing is sending him in so that he goes in ahead of me and by himself. So let's go ahead and get started. So when he makes active movements towards the trailer, that's when I'm going to let him rest. I'm going to take my whip and I'm going to drop it to the pole. Good boy. I'll let him investigate. Very good boy. Good boy. I'm going to take him away and we'll try again. Once I get him straight like that, headed towards the trailer more or less, that's when he gets to rest, and I'm going to rub him with this whip to reassure him that he did the right thing. I will come back and try again. Anytime he balks or backs away or gets sideways like that, I'm going to lift my hand and kind of point him into the trailer, and I'm going to start applying pressure from behind him with this whip. As soon as he takes even a small step in the direction I like, I'll put both my front hand down and I'll take my right hand and I'll rub him with that whip. So we're going to go at it again, see if I can get him straighter this time.
That's great progress right there. When he puts his head down and sniffs, it shows he's relaxed enough to lower his head and investigate his environment. So you'll notice when he takes his head and he kind of sticks it out looking over here, I just push it back inside the trailer and ask him to focus on what we're doing. Good. So just like that, I'm gonna throw his head back in the direction we want him to go. So I want to make sure and reward that right away. My goal right now is not to get him in the trailer, so to get him confident with approaching. So here we go. Good boy. He's already getting a lot more confident at approaching this trailer and approaching it straight, because he knows he gets rest and he gets a reward when he goes at this trailer straight and with confidence. So let's see if we'll take one more step now. Good boy.
Good boy.
Very good.
So proud.
And for anxious horses,
let me come under you, Bello.
I have an anxious horse too. Her name is Aurora. It's very easy to push anxious horses too far and to feed into their nervous tendencies. If I came in here and I was like, get in the trailer, and I put all this pressure on him, I could make him explode just like that. It's very easy to make them explode. So you just kind of have to take it at their pace, reward them for the little steps, and keep your own energy low. If I came in here looking for him to get in the trailer like that, his energy is gonna go through the roof because my energy is gonna be really high trying to get him into this trailer. When I take my energy low and slow and confident, I'm not in a hurry. We're not going anywhere today. We're just working on, good boy, good boy. When I take it slow, I show him there's nothing to be worried about. I just ask him for little bitty steps of progress. That's when his confidence is gonna soar. Good boy. Let's try it here. One more step. Good boy. Better. So I want this to become a relaxing place for him. Any pressure is going to happen when he tries to back up like that. But as soon as he comes back to me, that's where he gets to relax and have that release and that reward. Oh boy.
Take him around and go at it straight again. Chewing now because he knows he did the right thing. All the pressure happened when he was kind of unsure, swinging his butt side to side. I'm not going to let up the pressure. It's not a lot of pressure, but I'm still asking with my hand on his face. I'm still asking him to do something, good boy, with my voice. And I'm still lightly swinging this rope behind his hindquarters as pressure to ask him to go forwards. So I'm still going to keep up all that pressure whenever he's doing his sideways hip thing, whenever he's not lining straight up to the trailer, and whenever he's not taking steps forward. As soon as he takes one positive movement towards the trailer, that's when I'm going to let my pressure go and let him relax and feel that reward. Anxious horses like him get a huge reward from being allowed to relax. So he's going to seek that out actively because his mind is constantly going. Just like my anxious mare, her mind is constantly going. So she's going to constantly seek out situations where she gets to be safe, she gets to relax, she gets to rest. Good, better, good boy. His pressure is going to go while he's being sideways, while he's backing up, while he's doing any sort of jumbo. As soon as I get him straight again, I'll release this pressure. Good boy. Better. Good boy.
Good boy. Yay, yay,
good
yay. Oh
boy,
my god, yes.
Good.
All 4 feet. Do, do, do. Happy dance.
Mom, help.
Right? He's like, this lady, she won't give up.
No, I won't. Good, that's better.
So I have a question for you, Camille. How do you stop him from turning his butt to the right? Since that's
like
what,
that
yeah.
I just bring him back and point him straight again, but I don't really set pressure when he does it. So
solid.
I keep this going. And then sometimes he'll bring it back to me because
mm-hmm.
he knows this is where he gets the reward. But I just, if he's not going to bring it back to me, I just keep the pressure, I keep this pressure, I keep my hand pointing him into the trailer.
Okay.
So as soon as he goes straight again, that's when I release the pressure. And once that concept is more
in their brain,
yes, once he realizes he never gets rewarded for swinging his butt over here, he's never going to do it.
Okay.
Once he realizes he always gets rewarded for going straight into the trailer, he's always going to do it.
Okay.
Just like I'm never letting him get rewarded for backing up.
His lip. He's like, you deserve that.
When's the last time you got him in this trailer?
When I moved him here, May 1st.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How long did it take to get him in?
It took 4 people about 30 minutes.
Nice.
Not long, but the first time when I moved him to a different barn, it took us 3 hours.
Nice.
So.
Good boy. Very good boy.
Sorry, happy dance.
Good
So do you think this will take a couple, like, multiple lessons for him to get confident enough to be able to walk in? Okay.
But I think each time it's going to
get shorter and shorter.
Go in half.
Okay.
That's generally how it goes. Once you get them in once, where it's their idea, and I just point, that's my goal for today, is to get them in the trailer once with zero resistance.
Okay.
Once you get that, he gets rewarded for it. The trailer door doesn't close. We're not going anywhere. It doesn't get any more stressful. The next time you try, it's going to take like half as long.
Yay.
Next time, half as long. It's generally how it goes.
You'll definitely get a margarita out of this.
Hell yeah.
I'm not gonna save you. Definitely getting our workout in from this humidity.
It wasn't that bad earlier. I was out this morning working rocky.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't that bad, but it's getting worse as that rain comes in.
Right? I'm gonna walk over here because my phone's on the trailer. Okay.
I hope that doesn't affect anything.
Nah, he'll be fine. Just need to check it. Good boy. Good boy. And as he gets better, he can get pushed a little bit harder, too. I'm not going to push him very hard today. But once he knows his job and he's better at it, if he gives you crap, you can push him. And he's like, okay, I know, you know? Good boy.
So the record thing has 3 minutes and 45 seconds left. Do I press it again once it times out? Okay.
Yeah, just let me know and I'll go over there and check on it.
Good boy! Good boy. Oh, not good boy.
Good boy.
It's gonna say if it times out, we can always bring it closer too.
I have another memory card.
Ah. Good boy.
So he's had trouble getting his back feet on that ramp, and every time he's done it, he's backed off right afterwards. But this time I waited, I got his back feet on, I waited a few seconds. And then I made it my idea to get off the ramp. Because if he's gonna do it, I'd rather it be my idea than his idea.
Proud.
Like I said, I'm going to make it my idea to leave that trailer because I felt like he was going to back up on his own. But we'll go right back and try again. Some definite progress today. He didn't get quite as far as I wanted him to, but he did get in the trailer with only a little bit of hesitation, which is great progress for us to build on. Like I told Jules, they tend to get a whole lot better each time you work on this. So I expect the next time he will get in the trailer a whole lot faster. Won't you, buddy? And be a lot less anxious about it. His biggest problems are just he's a busybody. As you can see, he's always looking for something to do, some way to get rid of some of this energy, some of this anxiety. So that's his biggest struggle. But he did learn to relax on the ramp, and he was fairly relaxed when he got into that trailer. So he's starting to learn that the trailer is actually a reward and a relaxed spot rather than a place where he needs to get anxious. So buddy. So we'll see you guys again next time. Thanks for watching. Howdy everybody, it's Camille, and this is the thoroughbred Bello that has a problem with trailer loading. Today is day two, working with him on trailer loading. He's already a lot calmer around this area than he was the other day. As you can tell, he's not trying to eat grass as much or push me over as much. He kind of had a real, like, personal space issue yesterday because he got anxious and he tried to crowd my space and crowd Jules' space. So today, when I got him out of the pasture, first thing I worked on was backing him out of my space and not letting him in unless I asked him. And he's already a whole lot calmer now that I've established a few boundaries. So we're going to go ahead and get to work on trailer loading. And get him a little straighter here.
He's got to poop. Thank you. You could try working him hard off the trailer.
That would just get him worked up.
I think he already is.
Retreat is really working for him, so we're going to keep working on this. Good boy. So my end goal really isn't to get him on the trailer. It's to get him comfortable with approaching it and retreating it from it. If he gets really comfortable approaching that trailer, then he's just gonna get in with no problem. We're just trying to build his confidence. There we go. from backing out and or force him to stay in this trailer, because that'll ruin his confidence with approaching this trailer. So anytime he backs off, I just let him back all the way off, and I ask him to go straight back on again. Good boy. Well, that was day two of teaching Bello to overcome his trailering issues. We didn't make too much progress the first day, but today I'd say he made a really huge breakthrough, and he's going to be able to continue learning with his owner. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for more training videos like this one. Thanks!